Howdy y'all, welcome to the Dark Crystal Conjunction. I realize I have a icon over my face, but that's okay. That's what happens in the live stream. With me is Sean. Let me turn on the music. Since y'all are early, I did want to give you guys the code on how to get in, and then we'll do the formal intros. We'll give people about 3 minutes to wait, and that way I could send out all the little bursts on social media and whatnot. So I see there's already several of y'all in the room. So let's go into what this is gonna look like here. This is our second Dark Crystal Trivia for Thra-athon. What you're gonna do, this is how you're going to join. You are gonna be going to myquiz.org. So keep watching the live stream, but the main competition, all the info, all the good stuff you need to know is going to happen on myquiz.org. It's actually how you enter and join. This is the code you're going to enter there. If anyone gives you another number, they're liars and thieves, and you should not listen to them. The code you're going to need is 627090. Enter that code, 627090, and then join. I'll put this in the comments as well, or if someone else can throw that in there. 627090. Enter in your nickname, put something recognizable so we can see who's chatting in the YouTube chat. That way we can get about some good friendly banter and whatnot. To actually play, it's gonna ask you, they're all gonna be multiple choice questions. You select the right one, you hit answer, and fastest speed, the top three players are gonna get a bonus. At the end, the leaderboard is shown, tiebreakers will be decided via how fast you answered. So the winner will get a keyword, send that to us so we can verify you win. We'll see the names up here as well. And the winner is going to get a copy of Inside the Epic Return to Thra, signed by Toby Froud. So again, that code you're gonna wanna enter, go to myquiz.org and enter code 627090. I'm gonna give everyone about 3 minutes before I say all that again, and then we will formally start. Thank you. All right. Well, howdy, y'all, and welcome to the Dark Crystal Conjunction, your YouTube dream space to nerd out about all things the Dark Crystal. I'm your host, Jason Delgado. Welcome to the second trivia contest for the Thra-athon. If you remember this is the third Thra-athon, but this is only the second time we've done a trivia. Our last winner was Draco Star, and he did phenomenal, and we've upped the ante on the prizes. With me today, and also co-hosting with me for this trivia, is Sean. Sean, why don't you introduce yourself and give us a little info about this Thra-athon and what we're giving away today.
Yeah, absolutely. So my name is Sean. I run the Angle of Eternity page on Instagram, as well as the group on Facebook. And I'm the founder of the Thra-athon. And so today, we actually have an amazing prize. Let's see if I can hold it up here for you. We have a signed copy of Inside the Epic Return to Thra. It is signed by Toby Froud. And so that is going to go to our winner.
Next time, I want you to host this by yourself so that I can enter, because I love that prize. That's so awesome.
I'm not going to lie. I was like, yeah, I kind of wish I had one more of these for myself.
Oh, man, I know. This is a really great prize. I was super excited. I love doing the trivia just for fun. I'm glad when we can give away anything. Like, I had all those books were just extra books I had. They were new somehow. There was shipping errors or stuff sent for review, whatever. So I was happy to give it away and just spend money on shipping. But this prize is really great. So, well, without any further ado, let's go ahead and get started, and we will jump right into this.
All right, perfect. I will initiate the trivia.
Well, not the trivia yet. First, let me explain how people can join. If they were here a little early, they already got it. But let me give a little further explanation here. All right, so here are the instructions on how to join. I'm only going to go through this one time, so here it is. The way you're going to want to join is by going to myquiz.org. So leave up the YouTube on another device, whatnot, but myquiz.org is where you're going to want to watch. There is a couple second delay, so you're going to want to watch whatever device you have myquiz.org, another browser window, your phone, whatever. As someone already put in the comments, the code to enter is 627090. The code for, I'm going to type that in the chat as well, just to make sure, 627090. You're going to enter in that code, and once you do, it's going to ask you for your nickname. Put something family friendly and also something that relates to your YouTube, so we could get some good friendly banter and whatnot. Next, here's how you actually play. When the trivia begins, you will see several questions with several answers. All the questions and answers this time are going to be, there's no true or false, there's no which quote is this, they're all multiple choice. You have three choices. You're going to choose the right answer and then hit answer or submit. First three players who answer correctly get bonus points. At the end, a leaderboard is shown. The faster you are, that's how you could break ties. And that did matter in the last one. Second and third place in the last trivia tied point-wise, but one was about a minute faster total in all their answers collectively. And the winner, as we said, gets one of those copies of Inside the Epic Return to Thra signed by Toby Froud. So I am super excited for whoever gets that. And I'm a little bit jealous, but you know.
And it is the very last copy that we have.
Nice. Oh, are there several of these already been given away?
Yep, we had one that went to the winner of the art contest.
I should have entered. I should have entered that. That's cool. I would not have won that.
And then we also had one that went to the winner of the fan fiction.
Excellent. All right, so one last time, myquiz.org is the code, or the place you want to go. The code is 627090. And with that, let's go ahead. We already gave the instructions. What we're going to do, you're going to have about 15 seconds to answer. And then I think we put like 45 seconds before the next question answers. We might pause it if we talk a little bit. Hopefully we don't talk as long as we did last time. I know we went really long. But we do want to try to get it flowing. There are going to be 20 questions. So we'll be displaying the questions and whatnot up on here on the live stream as well, and the leaderboard as well. So with that, it's game on. So Sean, go ahead and read off the first question and get the quiz started. Again, all multiple choice. Here we go.
Hoxgeekska is the Skeksis word for what ritual? The ritual of renewal, imperial funerary rites, or trial by stone?
And man, those answers are flooding in. I love being able to see this live now. That was the one thing I regretted last. I was like, oh man, I wish I could. I would have rated to be able to see it. All right, and the answer.
The correct answer is trial by stone.
Now, what's currently displaying up there, I entered in to be able to display it, so it's going to say your answer is incorrect, but yep, there it is, trial by stone. Trial by stone. It's cool, too, because in the background of the movie, you could still hear him going, Haskiga, and stuff like that. So.
Yeah, I love it.
Yeah.
And it's interesting because I think that's one of the few terms that's actually in the Skeksis language, which was never actually translated or really changed.
Yeah.
It's one of the few times where you hear the actual Skeksis language in the film, which is really nice.
Yep, true. All right, keep it rolling, dude. Keep it rolling.
All right.
Oh, and look at this. Draco Star is back, and he already has first place. He does not want to lose his belt. We're going to have like a cage match and stuff, so.
I'm kind of glad in some ways that we're not involved in the contest, because if we were, we'd have to go up against him.
Yeah. Can he win it again? Let's see. All right. I'm still showing it. Pause. Did you get it going?
Yep. How many Urskeks arrive on Thra during the first great conjunction? 18, 10, or 12?
This can be a tricky one. But answers are flowing in. 3, 2, 1.
And the correct answer is 18. A total of 18 Urskeks arrived on Thra during the first great conjunction. During the second great conjunction, they were split into 18 Skeksis and 18 Uru. By the time of the film, only 10 remain, and then of course that very quickly turns into 8.
Very nice. And there you could see the 18 as the Creation Myths comic shows, you know, there's the 10 remaining at the end of the film, and there's their split. So go ahead and keep reading the questions. I'm going to try to change the format slightly of how it's displaying the My Quiz. That way we could see everyone. Draco Star is currently tied with Anthony. And I think this might be the same Anthony that's won a couple things from the raffle at the Great Conjunction.
Oh, interesting.
I think. Maybe he can chime in and let us know.
You've got some hardcore collectors, then, I would say.
Yeah.
Cool. Well, I will go up with the next question. How many trine years are there between each great conjunction? 300, 3,000, or 1,000? And the correct answer is 1,000. Each great conjunction occurs every 999 year and 1 years, which equals 1,000 trine. Jen's flute is called a what? A panpipe, a furka, or the recorder of order?
Did that one have like no time in between? Did it just go?
It did.
we'll just follow the quiz then. We'll just follow the quiz.
It, for some reason, did not register when I hit pause, so I was just like, all right, we're going with it.
All good.
And the correct answer is a furka. Jen's flute is called a furka, and its prominent Y-shaped structure is meant to evoke the triangular imagery used throughout the Thra. Whoop. Whoa, that went way too fast.
Well, it's already up, so go ahead question. And it's already up, right. Yeah.
I'm not sure what happened there. Which Skeksis has held all the titles of General, Gartha Master, and Emperor? Skekso, Skekung, or Skekvar?
Oh, I think the time in between questions is 10 seconds, so.
Oh, okay. We may have to pause a little bit more rigorously then.
Yeah, I thought it was going to be 45, so. All right, answers flowing. Oh, currently Sonya's up top. Draco Star's second. Mazo's tied with
so
Draco Star.
The correct answer was, of course, Skekung. Well, Skekso was the first emperor of the Skeksis, and Skekvar was the first general. It's Skekung who, at one point or another, had all three titles during the events of the film.
Oops. I just went to the stream is not concluded. There we go. I love Skekung's design. He's just such a great character. All right, next question.
Jim Henson was drawn to Brian Froud's artwork through which book? Once Upon a Time, Fairies, or The Land of Froud? And the correct answer is the Once Upon a Time. Once Upon a Time is a 1978 book collecting contemporary fantasy illustrations by Brian Froud and Alan Lee. Henson was impressed by Froud's work, but was particularly impressed by the cover image featuring a giant troll with a waterfall running down his nose.
Yep, and Henson originally wanted those trolls in his movie, but due to copyright, he couldn't. And so Froud's like, I just drew two more arms on them, and they became the Uru. That's all it was. So two arms as a troll. Four arms is an Uru.
Alrighty. Jason, do you want to take the next question, or would you like me to take that?
I will attempt to take the next question.
All right.
Do or do not, there is no try. All right. Oh, this one's a very interesting one. This is some good background info right here. What book did Jim Henson recommend his crew read before production? A. The Magician's Nephew by C.S. Lewis. B. Seth Speaks by Jane Roberts. Or C. The Lord of the Rings by J.R.R. Tolkien. Answers flowing in. Currently Sonia's first still. Or Sonia. Mazad second. Barely beating Draco Star. And the correct answer was Seth Speaks. Though there are certainly some similarities between Henson's fantasy work and the writings of Lewis and Tolkien, Henson suggested that the examples of the Gnostic, Buddhist, and Hindu spirituality found in Jane Roberts' Seth Speaks inspired his ideas for The Dark Crystal most. Yeah, he was handing out those books, and I remember even in one interview, someone mentions like, yeah, he would tell us, like, I don't exactly know what it means, but you need this. And that really does help make Thrall otherworldly and really not seem anything earthly, so it was effective, his strategy.
Well, and it's interesting too, because it ties into a lot of the same philosophical subject matter that Brian Froud was really interested in, and so I think it was kind of a nice point of mutuality between the two, where they kind of were on the same page, so it was a good introduction for everyone involved.
Yep. Oh, and look at this. Ian, who was like one of the first ones in the chat, he's like, oh, my brain is as slow as an Uru. I'm going to be so slow at this. There's 50 people, and I'm going to try to not be 50th. I think there's more in now. That was in the first thing. And Sonia is second, and Mazan is third, tied with Draco Star, who's third also. So there's – and Eveline is third as well. Wow, they all have tied for it. So we have a three-way tie for third right now. So, all right, let's keep it moving. Let's see where this goes. That's very Thraw. That is very Thraw. All right, prepare for the next question here. I'll go ahead and – I think we can switch off now, so why don't you go ahead and read this one.
All right. When designing the Poglings in Gartham, Brian Froud drew inspiration from what two foods? Stuffed mushrooms and salmon, gyoza and sashimi, or potatoes and lobsters? I love this. It's just so whimsical.
This is a great one, yeah.
And the correct answer is potatoes and lobsters. When designing the Podlings in Gartham, Brian Froud was thinking of baked potatoes and lobster dinner. Apparently he had lots of lobster dinner during the early stages of production, and that was just something that that resonated with him, and that's how the Gartham wound up with their hard kind of crepuscular shells.
Yep, I love it. All right, next, let's keep it going. I love that Mike Plug concept art too, or...
Yeah, that's terrific.
I love that one. All right. Before becoming the maternal nature goddess of Thra, we all know and love, Agra was known as what? A. Jareth the Goblin King, B. Morla the Ancient One, or C. Abitabad the Wizard? Morla the Ancient One is not the answer. The answer is Habitabad the Wizard. While Morlo the Ancient One and Jerry the Goblin King are iconic from other 80s fantasy films, one must wonder if Agra's initial concept and name of Habitabad the Wizard would have caught on with fans. I think we can all be grateful we wound up with a three-eyed Agra. So there you go. That grotesque goddess. You gotta love her.
I don't think that Habitabad would have caught on. There's just something about, I think we've had too many male wizards, and I think we needed something a little bit more ancient and kind of mysterious.
Yep. So. And as someone pointed out in the chat, yes, Morla is from the NeverEnding Story, and Jareth, of course, from Labyrinth. So.
Yeah. And Jareth, right. Of course, is, you know, another great Brian Froud, Jim Henson collaboration character.
Yep. That was a tricky one. Only 28% got that. Most people thought it was Morla. 71% thought it was Morla. Wow. All right. Let's go.
The herbalist Ernol is misidentified in the credits of the original film by which title? The Gardener, the Apothecary, or the Hunter? Ooh. And this was actually something that I only found out about a year and a half ago or so.
I only found out due to Age of Resistance.
Yeah, no, a fan asked me, and then I was like, well, you know. And so, for some reason, Ernol, who is primarily performed by Sui Lim, is misidentified as the Hunter in the credits, a title which was later used in canon for Skekmal. If you go through the World of Froud book, he is correctly identified as the Herbalist, but yet, for some reason in the credits, he's the Hunter.
Yeah, apparently someone on set had said that was his original name, but then they deemed it too aggressive for an Uru. And so that's when they changed it. But then it's interesting because then you get an archer later on in Age of Resistance. Of course, he's the other half of the Hunter, which is a lot more the most aggressive Skeksis we've seen. So,
but. Well, it's also interesting with the archer because other than Skekmal, I don't think we ever actually see him shoot at anything. So it seems like, you know, the only aggression he's really afforded is towards his Skeksis, you know, counterpart, which is kind of interesting. I wonder if that's like an exemption, you know?
Right.
You can't harm others, but you can harm the other version of yourself.
Exactly. Yeah. So, all right. Next, what do we got?
All right. And you want to take this next one?
Yes, sir.
All right. Sounds good.
All right. We still have Ian on top, Sonya, and Draco Star closely following up, so. Which Jim Henson puppet series foreshadowed the Dark Crystal? A, The Land of Gorch, B, Fraggle Rock, or C, Sesame Street? For the record, I love me some Fraggle Rock. I think Fraggle Rock was like the successor, but it wasn't the predecessor though, so. But let's see. The answer is The Land of Gorch, which was early on, it was in the Saturday Night Live series that Henson created that dealt with some gruff-looking monsters, as you can see from the, let me switch over the slide there. They only appear in the first season of Saturday Night Live before being retired. And I love that joke that one says, Scred, you know why I drink? It's because I hate myself. Oh, that explains why I drink. I hate you too.
So it is good. A classic joke. It's so vintage Jim Henson.
Exactly.
Just a little rough around the edges, but still very kind of affable.
Exactly. So,
that's interesting. 55% of people thought that it was Fraggle Rock, and nobody at all guessed Sesame Street.
Yeah. Now, he was planning to do Fraggle Rock during Dark Crystal. There was some stuff going on there, but yeah, Fraggle Rock comes after Dark Crystal. Chronologically.
If I remember correctly, I think he kind of came up with the idea of Fraggle Rock like right around 1978 or so, which was right around the time that he had hired Brian Froud to work on the Dark Crystal.
Okay. All right. Let's see what is next. Still anyone's game. That's right. It is your turn. Go ahead.
What was the original title for the Dark Crystal when Jim Henson first conceived of the idea for it? The Chrysalis, the Darkening, or the Crystal of Mithra?
This is a tricky one.
It is.
This is a very tricky one. Sean and I actually debated this one a little bit.
And so the correct answer is the Chrysalis. Originally, Jim Henson wanted to tell the story of a species of creatures that changes from evil to good, and this was reflected by a physical transformation that they were going through. And so he was going to convey this through the symbol of a chrysalis. Brian Froud recalls that he misheard the title, which resulted in the symbol being changed to a crystal.
Yeah, and actually, I was watching the Dark Crystal film, original film with Brian Froud's commentary, and he says, Jim said, what's this crystal then? I said, well, it's what you've been going on. He said, oh, I thought we meant chrysalis, not crystal. And he felt the movie was about transformation. And a chrysalis was symbolic of that, but I misheard it. And that's how the film ended up with a dark crystal, not chrysalis. So, very, very tricky one. Yeah, I'm not surprised.
I can't help but wonder, you know, we've all talked about the Wall of Destiny and that one winged Gelfling. And I can't help but wonder if maybe that might have been a holdover, that the idea was initially that both female and male Gelflings had wings, and that maybe that Gelfling went through some sort of transformation and grew wings, but we'll never know.
Yep, could be. All right, I got the next one. The original name for the planet of Thra was Arth, Mithra, or Gorch. If you paid attention to the last couple of questions, you already know which one it's not. Hopefully, maybe. Answer is flowing in. Ooh, Ian has a nice 10-point lead now, but anything can happen. And the answer is Mithra. The original name for Thra was Mithra, but its name being the same as a deity in the ancient pre-Zoroastrian religion called Mithraism, they didn't want it to be related to anything on Earth, basically. So that's what we got there. And it's interesting, even as you can see from the PowerPoint there, M-Y-T-H-R-A is how Odell even spelled Mithra. So, but they wound up deciding to shorten it, and the credit for that usually goes to Brian Froud actually shortening it. All right, what do we got next?
In the original pitch book for what would become the Dark Crystal, the title is known as what? The Chrysalis, the Crystal, or the Dark Crystal?
Oh, that was already showing? Oops. Pro production here. Hopefully, I told you guys, pay attention to your devices with my quiz, not us. This is a good question, too. If you've watched some of my original videos, this should be a very easy one. I did a whole series on this.
And the correct answer is the original pitch book, which later made available as a facsimile edition in the classic The World of the Dark Crystal, was simply called The Crystal. At that point, they had moved away from the Chrysalis title due to Brian Froud's rather fortuitous error.
Yeah. Yep. All right. Ian still on top. Sonia second. Draco Star third. Still got six more questions. Which puppeteer performed Fizzgig in the 1982 film? A. Carol Spinney, B. David Groles, or C. Steve Whitmire? He also did perform a Fizzgig in in Age of Resistance. The answer is Dave Groles. All three performers have celebrity history with Jim Henson Company, but it was Dave Groles who performed Fizzgig. Of course, if you performed any puppet in this, you can perform other things. So there's a picture there of him performing, working with the podling type stuff. But yeah, he also did Baffy in Age of Resistance as well, as you can see there. So.
And one of the things I love is if you actually go back and watch the World of the Dark Crystal documentary, which is available, I think, on all of the DVDs and Blu-rays, when they talk about kind of Dave Gold's involvement with Skekgung, they show the wonderful footage of Skekgung, you know, piling, you know, spaghetti noodles into his mouth, just dangling everywhere. He looks so grotesque.
Apparently that was his idea, right? They said.
I think so. I know that he struggled with the crawlies that were running along the table because he could barely see them. And there was a point where he was supposed to kind of stab down with his fork and get one of them. And so I kind of wonder if he was like, you know what, I'm just going to shovel, you know, spaghetti into my Skeksis mouth, because that's a lot easier than trying to find this darn crawly.
Yep. Something that's not alive. All right. Sanja shortened the lead. It's only a 6-point difference between first and second.
Wow.
We may have a new belt title, Earl. We'll see.
Although puppeteered by Frank Oz, the voice for Augur was provided by which raspy voiced actress? Pat Welsh, Marianne Faithfull, or Billy Whitelaw? Yeah, And the correct answer is Billy Whitelaw. Billy Whitelaw provided the unforgettable voice performed for Agra. Fun fact, Pat Welch, however, helped to voice E.T. for Steven Spielberg that same year. Hmm. 1982 was a very good year for fantasy and science fiction.
Indeed, indeed. All right, what do we got next? Ooh, Ian still. All right, which Erskek addresses the Gelfling at the end of the original film? A. Zaxa, B. Tekti, or C. Ung-Im? Ooh, I saw our leader not being the first to answer. Will this change the lead? Well, it depends if people get the answer right, of course.
It may. We'll see.
The answer is Ung-Im. In a moment of dramatic irony, it is indeed Ung-Im, the Erskek leader, comprised of the brutish Skek Ung and sluggish Ur-Im, who heals Kira and imparts wisdom to Jen before leaving Thra. And there you can see there, this artwork by David Peterson. Of course, he did these for the comics. And then there's the Ung-Im at the end of the movie there. That is a kind of cool, I guess, redemption story for one of the most brutish type Skeksis.
Very
interesting.
He kind of goes from being sort of the most, you know, brutish and savage, and kind of evolves into becoming the most intellectual. And, you know, I think about kind of like what Catherine Mullen had to say about how Jim was so focused on taking the two opposite aspects of a character and bringing them together to kind of create this super being, mm-hmm. you know, who sort of had the benefits of both. And so it's kind of interesting to see someone who goes from being the most unlikable and kind of unsophisticated character to becoming the most philosophical and kind of the leader. It's an interesting paradigm to suggest in essentially a children's film with puppets.
Right, yeah.
Some pretty deep stuff going on.
Craziest puppet show ever. All right.
What three team members of the production team on Empire Strikes Back also worked on The Dark Crystal? George Lucas, Phil Tippett, and Frank Oz? George Lucas, Gary Kurtz, and Kenny Baker? Or Gary Kurtz, Frank Oz, and Wendy Froud, Nay Meidner?
That last question, 50% got it right. Let's see what this percentage is here.
Impressive. The correct answer is Gary Kurtz, Frank Oz, and Wendy Froud, Nay Meidner. Gary Kurtz produced, Frank Oz performed puppets, and Wendy Froud worked in puppet fabrication for both films. Iconic.
Yep.
And so we are looking at 66.7% got the correct answer for that one.
Oh, and Sonia just took the lead. She's up by 2 points, beating Ian. He's at 92, she's at 94, and the Huberman Project is at 81. Good job, Elise. That's her real name. I don't know if I should have said that. All right. What three members of... Oh, that's the same question. Hold on. Wait for it. All right. Which actor doubled as a Gelfling in The Dark Crystal and as a Hobbit in the Lord of the Rings trilogy? Kieran Shaw, Deep Roy, or Billy Bardi? This one I would have got. There's a couple of these in here with actors that I would have missed probably because that's not my strong point. The answer is Kieran Shaw. Deep Roy did do stunt work on The Dark Crystal, and he appeared in Tim Burton's Charlie and the Chocolate Factory, whereas Billy Bardi appeared in Willow. But it was Kieran Shaw who doubled as both a Gelfling and a Hobbit. And man, that's such a great, like, you tell your kids, like, dude, I was a Gelfling and a Hobbit. That's just,
yeah,
you win.
It's pretty wonderful, and you don't see a whole lot of either Deep Roy or Kieran Shaw in the behind-the-scenes materials for The Dark Crystal.
Yep.
But they do definitely get their props later on in their careers, and one of my favorite things from the Lord of the Rings special features is you've got some wonderful footage where Viggo Mortensen, who plays Aragorn, had like a curry competition with Kieran Shaw, where Kieran was like, no, your fish is not spicy enough. You need to add more curry.
Nice. I love that little in the Lord of the Rings, one of the behind the scenes, it shows him dressed up as Legolas too. And he's just, he's going to battle. And it's a hilarious little behind the scenes, little 1 minute film they did.
Yeah.
It's great.
I think that was from The Return of the King.
It's so nerdy.
It's when Legolas was doing the slide down the elephant's trunk.
That sounds right. Yeah. All right. So we have one question left. Currently first place is still Sonia. She's at 101 points. Ian has fallen to second place. He's at 97 points. Hupperman Projects at 87 points. Draco Stars at 75 points. And Anthony, who was first previously, is at 74 points. So, last question. Here we go.
It's really anyone's game. 61% got that last question right. So, we'll see how this goes.
We will see how this goes. In 5, 4. In addition to scoring, which one is us? Oh, it's your turn. Go for it.
In addition to scoring the Dark Crystal, Trevor Jones also scored which fantasy film with the word dark in the title? Dark City, Army of Darkness, or Thor the Dark World?
Now, being a huge fan of Trevor Jones, I would have got this one right. I do like the other two films.
And the correct answer is, of course, Dark City. Dark City is a 1998 cult classic science fiction fantasy film. It was directed by the same director who directed The Crow. And it's also one of Trevor Jones' best works. It's really great, great soundtrack.
Indeed. All right, so who was our winner here?
It looks like we have a new winner.
Sonia, congratulations, clocking in at 2 minutes and 4 seconds, 106 points. Ian, clocking in at 2 minutes and 10 seconds, it may have been the seconds that made a difference also, 104 points, wow, only a 2-point difference. And they were way ahead of anyone else after that. Huberman Project got 87, Anthony 76, Cecil 78, our former champion is 6th place, Draco Star 75, and onward it goes. Thanks everyone for participating. There's your little first place graphic there. So last time when Draco, we could kind of joke like, oh man, it'd be great if we had a trophy of like Skekung doing his ha 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 ha. So there's the animated GIF for there. Sonia, I hope that you post that GIF, wear the belt, you get the prize, you get the book signed by Toby Froud. So congratulations on that. Before we head out, any final words you want to give, Sean?
No, not really. I'm just happy to be here and happy to have everyone involved that has been involved. We will be doing future Thra-athons. We're a little bit unsure of what it's going to look like next year just because of the whole thing with the pandemic and people's availability to be involved. But stay tuned. There will be more to come.
Oh, cool. Well, with that, Sanja, make sure that you contact Ian or myself. It should have given you an email address or a code or something like that. That way we could make sure we get your address to send you this awesome prize that we're both jealous that we don't have. So anyways, congratulations. Thanks everyone for participating. Hope you learned something new. Hope you all had fun. And until next time, keep exploring Thra.
Perfect.